Hello everyone, I'm Harry, welcome to my channel, and today we're going to do another How to Sound Like video, so we're going to try and get the torrent on Ruby by Kaiser Chiefs. I should say I managed to find the multi-tracks online for this, which really helped me get closer to the original torrents because I can isolate the guitars and hear it better. So the only things that you're hearing in the original song are the drums, bass, the little synth thing that comes in, because I thought at the beginning that big swell in was like a feedback note, but it's actually a synth, so I didn't do that on guitar. So you're only hearing the drums, bass, vocals and the synth parts, all the guitar parts and my guitar parts that I recorded in. So a lot of Kaiser Chiefs stuff really isn't my thing, but this is a great rocky stadium anthem type thing and has some great guitar tones going on as well. So being Kaiser Chiefs, I had to do a little bit of research, and the guitarist out of Kaiser Chiefs uses a ES-335 style guitar a lot. So for this, I'm using my 1958 reissue ES-335 with Monty's low output PAF humbucking pickups. The amp he tends to use is like a Marshall Bluesbreaker, which is like a JTM-45 combo. So the amp I'm using is this lovely Cornell 4550. So the Cornell 4550 had settings like this. Again, we were in the 45 mode, which gives us the true rectifier, just like a JTM-45 style Marshall would have. This is hands down one of the best plexis I've played. I've used it in a couple of videos so far. I got this recently and it's really killer. So go and check out Cornell stuff. There'll be links in the description. So the Cornell 4550 plexi was running into my Universal Audio Arch just to attenuate ever so slightly. And then that was running into two Celestion G12M65 Creamback speakers and then being recorded by the Lewitt LCT640TS condenser microphone and the MTP440 dynamic microphone. If at any point in this video you enjoy it, please leave a like, comment and subscribe and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot and that way you won't miss out on my future uploads. So as usual, there's going to be links in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. They are affiliate links, I'd really appreciate it if you go and check them out. So I had the Cornell set very clean so we could get like the verse clean parts going on. And then to get the main overdrive sound, I actually used the Organic Spice Booster by Torino Audio. This is a killer flexible boost pedal. Their whole ethos is to keep things as simple in the signal chain as possible. So there's actually only three active elements, which keeps you connected straight to your tone rather than going through loads of processing. It sounds really killer and pushes the Marshall right into that right gain stage that we need for these tones. So I recently did a full demo of the Organic Spice by Torino Audio. So if you'd like to see that, there'd be a link up in the cards, in the description and pinned in the comments. I had the same settings on the Cornell the whole way through and I just turned the Torino Audio pedal on and off. So if I quickly show you what it sounds like going straight into the Cornell and then with the pedal on. So straight into the Cornell sounds like this. And then with the Torino Audio Organic Boost, boosting it to get us the overdrive tone sound like this. So on the pretty little chords thing that comes in through the verse and like the little break bridge thing, there is a very slight delay on. It's quite a quick one with like one or two repeats and it's a bit darker. So for that, I was using the Source Audio Collider. This is a killer multi-delay and reverb pedal. And we actually used the reverb later on as well for the solos and the main lead lines. So I was just in the analog modes and had a quick repeat and set like that. So I'll quickly show you what that sounds like. I can't show you the controls because I saved the preset and the controls have moved since, so it doesn't line up, but you'll be able to hear exactly what's going on. And then for the reverb on like the little lead lines and the solo, I actually used the hall setting again with quite a small decay and a low mix, but it really does just give us that bit more spacey sound that we hear on the original. So with the hall setting on the Source Audio Collider, it sounds like this. So for pretty much all of the parts in this, it was either double or triple tracked. So when I pull out the main guitar line, like all the chords and the riff and stuff, I'm going to pull out it with all the double track and just show the one video. All the tracks were exactly the same settings on the amp and the Torino audio. The only thing that changed was in the little chord things that the Source Audio came on with the analog delay. So I'm going to pull that track isolated out from the intro song. You'll see the settings of the Torino Audio Organic Boost on the screen as it's playing, and you'll just hear on the pretty chords when the Source Audio pedal comes in for the delay. So the only thing to note is on the pretty little chords in the verse and the bridge, the Torino Audio Boost gets kicked off straight into the Plexi, and then with the little analog delay from the Source Audio Collider. So the main guitar parts isolated from the intro song sound like this. Okay, so now we're going to look at the lead lines. So for the little lead lines, there's this lead line that comes in the verse 2, where it's like... So that's really simple. I did have the Torino Audio Boost on, but I was using the hall setting on the Source Audio Collider just to get that spacey sound. And those two pedals were both on for the solo as well. The only thing to note in the solo was it was double tracked, like the main lower octave was double tracked left and right, and then there's a higher octave that comes in that's dead center. Again, same settings on the Boost and Source Audio Collider, it's just all mixed in there together. So I'm going to pull those lead lines out. I'm going to leave them all mashed together because it's all the same settings anyway, and you can kind of get context. The only thing to note is we have the Torino Audio Boost on running into the Plexi. Again, you'll see settings of that on screen. And then we're just using the whole reverb and the Source Audio Collider, which I showed you at the beginning of the video. So that's for all the lead lines. So the lead lines isolated from the intro song sound like this. Again, you'll see the settings of the Torino Audio pedal on screen, and just note that the collider is on there as well.
We'll be right back.
So that's it, really. It's quite a simple song settings-wise. It's just important to get that plexi tone nailed. And of course, if you want to do it all in one, you have to have the plexi set clean and then having Summit boosting it. But it sounds like he's boosting it anyway because it's quite bass-heavy and quite presency and quite scooped sounding, which isn't normally something you get out of the plexi. So I thought the Cornell really came in handy for this and nailed all the parts, having those clean chords and then boosting it with the Torino Audio Organic Spice really got us that main overdrive tone. And then the Source Audio Collider helping us get an analog delay for the pretty verse parts and a good hall reverb on the lead lines. And of course, the key part of this was double tracking and hard panning right and left. So you're kind of playing the same thing. There was some little variations in there that I copied from the original, but you get the idea. And then double tracking the octave solo and then adding the higher octave on top really got us closer to the original's track. So again, if you want to see my full demo of the Organic Spice booster pedal by Torino Audio, there'll be a link up in the cards, in the description, and pinned in the comments. Let me know down in the comments how close you thought I got to the original song and any future House Soundlight videos you'd like to see me do. There's going to be affiliate links in the description to every piece of gear I used and every piece of gear I used to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate it if you go and check them out. If you did like that House Soundlight video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot. That way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. Go and check out some of my social media accounts. Got Instagram, Facebook, everything like that, and my Patreon page, where you can actually get some isolated tracks from the Soundlight, some tabs from my covers, some isolated tracks from the covers and so on. Other than that, go onto my channel, check out some of my playlists. I have plenty more lessons, covers, gear demos, House Soundlight videos, and anything guitar related. As always, I've been Harry, and thanks for watching.